Shayla, and welcome to Making Connections Worldwide. This week, our topic is social media, and I wanted to take that time for my subtopic to be using social media for bad. So people use social media badly all the time, and so many different people have addressed it, and nobody can say it enough that lots of people use social media as an excuse to be mean to people and to bully, because it is way easier to comment on someone's photo that they're ugly or to wish death on someone just by typing and then clicking send than it is to actually say it to their face. A lot of people just say that the haters are just gonna hate, but honestly, there's a part of that that is true. But the haters aren't just haters. The haters are bullies. They're just mean people. And I feel like it needs to be stopped. This is a system. It's just evolving, and people get picked on and then they go and pick on other people. It's like it's this routine that needs to be stopped. And so I think the best thing to do if you are being bullied right now, whether it is in person or it is online or through social media, ignore them. I've been bullied before too, and I noticed that the easiest way to just ignore them is to not care what they say, which can be hard in some cases, but honestly, the only person's opinion in your life that really matters is your own. If someone else is hating on you and making you hate you, then that needs to stop. You just need to ignore them, because you are you, and you would not be you if it weren't for these unique things that some people have and some people don't. So many people are affected by cyberbullies all the time, and words can really hurt people. I just happen to be one of those people that I've never really cared what other people thought about me. I don't know why I was that child. Like, when I did get bullied, it didn't really affect me to the point where I cared, because if someone is my friend and decides they want to pick on me and they want to be rude and call me names, then they're not really a friend. I don't want them to be a part of my life if they're gonna be rude to me. So I just ignored them, which is what I think everyone should do. Leave them alone. They don't need to be in your life if that's how they're gonna treat you. It's just not nice. It's not a good thing to be around. You want to be around positive people that will support you and that will encourage you to do things you love to do. People that will be there for you when you need them to. You don't need someone there that's going to use sarcastic remarks after everything you say. You don't need someone that's going to be extremely rude in situations that you're very vulnerable. But I think the biggest issue with social media is that when you get bullied in person, it's in person. It is usually at school, or it is somewhere other than your home. And if someone does pick on you at your home, you have the right to say, leave. But if someone is picking on you while you're in the comfort of your own home through one of your devices, on one of your social media accounts, tell them to stop. And if they don't stop, then just cut them from your life. Be yourself. Continue to be yourself. Continue to be you. Most bullies are just looking for a reaction. They just want to be noticed. They're attention seekers, either because they don't get attention at home, or they're just attention hogs, and that's all they want is attention from everyone all the time. So when someone is bullying you, it is most likely because they're jealous of something you have, or they don't like you and they don't know how to like show it, or they do like you and they want to be your friend and they don't know how to be your friend. There are so many different factors, and there's so many different lives being lived every day that bullies really go through a lot themselves. They just don't know how to deal with it emotionally. So they go out and they pick on people and they bully people and they make people feel bad about themselves. They make people feel the way that they feel about themselves. It's their reflection of themselves. Like if someone says, oh my gosh, you're such an they're reflecting off of themselves. Or if someone is like commenting on something like, wow, you're materialistic, then they're talking to a mirror. As long as you believe in you, as long as you love you, as long as you are you, when other people say mean things to you, or when other people are just mean in general towards you or your family, it is a lot easier to just ignore them and walk away. Focus on yourself, be as nice as you can be, and ignore them. Thank you guys so much. I hope you liked this video. We will be having other social media weeks, and I'm pretty sure this will not be the one and only time where we'll be addressing the topic social media or cyberbullying in general. So leave a comment below if there's anything you think I missed about a tip for people, and just promote positive energy towards social media, because social media is such a huge advancement. Technology is such a huge advancement. It would be terrible if it just got used for bad all the time. Help promote good throughout the world, because the more good you have, then the better off everyone will be. Okay, so think before you speak. There are many ways to avoid other people from hurting. If you think before you type, that's even better. Social media is used for bad in so many different ways. I would love to see more of you guys using it for good. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next week. Bye! When friends are gone, I know I save you. The love is real. You know it's real. 'Cause you got the love. You got the love. You got the love. I don't know. I feel like I'm bossing you around. You don't have to. I'm just recommending it. If you have a choice between bullying someone and not bullying someone, please choose not to. You got the love.